High doses of adversity can change the structure and function of children's developing brains, their developing immune system, their developing hormonal systems, and even the way their DNA is read and transcribed. Those changes are what we now refer to as the toxic stress response. Okay, as a doctor, I may be the one who's screening for adverse childhood experiences, but I might see that child at the most, you know, a couple times a year. But educators deliver the daily doses of healing interactions that truly are the antidote to toxic stress. And so the opportunity to do things like social emotional learning, to give children tools to understand how to recognize what's going on with them, and then how to respond, especially to be able to calm their bodies down, truly is healing. If you have a child who is being defiant, who is acting out, who is having a terrible time with impulse control, especially if they're experiencing high doses of adversity at home, suspending them so that they can go home and be in that environment may be doing more harm than good. We obviously need school safety policies and policies to support the orderly functioning of the school environment. But things like in-school suspensions, things like restorative justice, literally the time and space to allow those adrenaline and cortisol levels to come down. And it could be 15 minutes to have, you know, time and space in a quiet area to get back to self-regulation. That's a way to work with a child's biology instead of working against the child's biology. We have an overactive stress response. There's cortisol, there's adrenaline, there's all these stress hormones, and those are what leads to long-term harms. So I just went through the science and said, okay, well, what does the opposite? And it turns out that meditation, and I was skeptical at first, meditation helps to regulate the part of the brain associated with recovery post-provocation. It's associated with reduced levels of cortisol and other stress hormones, and also reduced physiologic indicators, things like blood pressure and heart rate. After reading that literature, I implemented a program in my clinical practice where we really taught mindfulness practices as part of our treatment protocol for kids with toxic stress.